Welcome back on the show. It's a beautiful morning here in Kabale. Right behind me, where I'm standing here, is the heart of Kigezi region.
When you are done today, Jemo walked on today.
The place you see here, right behind me, you can see, this is a place where you can do your shopping. Everything here, okay? And remember, we had the battery issue. So this is the time to fix the battery, and then we take you to another region. So it's time to take you to the resorts. Don't go away. Let's go and fix the battery first. I see you. Well, if you have ever been to Kabale, you probably know this place. Right behind me, it's the garage place. That's where you find all the mechanics. Okay, my battery can comfortably start. Okay, it starts very well. But you know what happened to us the other day, deep down in the jungle. So I thought of another solution. Okay, like I told you, never risk. I don't want to risk again. Because if I didn't have the other gentleman, I could not manage it. So I want to change this and remove it. So, this is the old one. I'm going to remove and replace this. Okay? See, I'm good to go. The tires are fixed, the battery is fixed. Let me first show you Kabale, and then we take you to the resorts. Thanks for traveling with Darius. The hill where I'm standing is called Makanga Hill. You know, behind me, this is the golf course. And then when I was growing up, they used to tell me this is a rich man's place. This used to be the administrative hill for Kigezi. You know, most of the good hotels in Kabale, Kabale town, they are here. We slept right behind here. And then on the other extreme here, that is Lake Bushenyi. And then on my right here behind is where we are heading. We are going to across Ntungamo, then Bushenyi. We connect to Queen Elizabeth National Park, and then we get to the resorts. Basically, from Queen Elizabeth National Park up to the other side is resorts. Indigenous people here are called Bachiga. We can't wait to take you to resorts. Welcome back on the show. Thanks for traveling with Darius. This place where I am is called the Rwai Trading Center, and it happens to be the border point for Kabale and Tungamo. Kabale is called the Switzerland of Africa. Reason being, it's cold, you know, you freeze. You freeze from there. Coldness stops here, the hills stop here, and basically the main economic activity in this place is agriculture, and you never run short of food in this area. You can see the fields out there, bananas somewhere there, everything around, everything called food. For some of you who are good at traveling, you know, this trading center is known for onions. So many cages of onions. Somewhere around the road there. Bachiga are known to be hardworking people. They are known to be friendly people. They want to come close and say hello. They don't mind the road. They want to greet each other. If you miss something like that in Kabale, then you know you yourself, you're hostile. Well, the part of Africa is known to be a place of friendly people. But when it comes to Bachiga, it's more exciting than that. Well, I can't wait to take you to Fort Portal. Bye bye, my friend. See you. As you come from Kabale, which is straight there where I'm coming from, the first district you come to is Tungamo. And then for you guides and tour operators and the rest who probably don't know the roads, this is the first town you get into, but you kind of dodge it from the side. So if you're probably a lonely traveler or you're a group and you don't understand the road, that's why we are always here. That town behind me is called Tungamo, and this place is, I think Tungamo was also in Kigezi, but if you see the trends and the culture here, it looks more of Ankole than Bachiga. It's a mixture of Banyankore, Banyarwanda and Bachiga, but their culture, the way they dress, their style of living, most of them look like Banyankore. You can see a lot of farms around, you can see a lot of matoke, which is not a common feature in Kabale. You can see, this is Queen Elizabeth National Park poster here. Okay, that's what we are going to take on our way to the Rwenzori's. Just follow me. Welcome back on the show, and thanks for traveling with Darius. Just few miles from the junction, there's something you see. And you know, it has always stayed at the back of my mind, because at A-level geography, photography interpretation, I failed the question. First of all, I didn't know where it was. First of all, I didn't know what it was. But you know, as you travel, something comes into your mind. It has stayed for long. This time to look at it. It's called Karegyeya, as you can see here. So it's a lock called Karegyeya lock. I want to ask some gentlemen, we were also looking at the rock and have some idea of what it is. Of course, geographers have their own version, and then the locals have their own version. Seba ni mkavachi?
Yes.
Ni wakweto hasebo?
Banyita Seba Kadekadidi.
Seba Kadekadidi. Omri nyakone na mwani, Seba Kadidi?
Ya, anu Muganda.
Oh, uri Muganda?
Ni Muganda.
Ye, jeba liko sebo?
Yes.
Nukavachi sebo?
Yes.
Ni wakweto hasebo?
Banyita Tunomcha
Edward. Tunomcha Edward. Edward not at home?
Ah,
sebo. Ngambira naura no manyuru nyankore eribare no manye byayo
eribare ryo kureberyo kwasirwa hemeze keshatu
emeze shatu
umwe no gure gusaide eki
okay
so eribare rkazaho ahabwa abachweze
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 aba muri yankore
bakaba baturabine haho eibabe bastama
batubibe
kwabo ko haho kamwe kajyaho
ubutege bwa abachweze
abachweze
eibabe
bastama azo mukutama kwabo
Hey.
So, I take a hitch to Java to Yangu Takata.
Weren't you once free, my Senegal? Long ago, long ago, long ago, long ago.
So, you have money in the Hinduka?
Uh-huh.
How could I?
Uh-huh.
Now, when I was on the cover, just hook with our glasses, we are going to go to the fire. But I am a get to our never in Kahaji.
I am a
Kamunojota, which you ever.
Thanks for traveling with Darius. Let's show you the details of the rock. Let me get there. All of you who studied geography since 1990s and so on, you have always had this, you have always read about this, and then here it is. Let's go. I basically don't know if I'll find the snake, as they said. In case I'm swallowed, guys, remember. This is Karegyeya Rock. Karegyeya, as much as I understand, it means something hanging on the ear. It's on the ear or on the arms. You always see children who are born with things like this. I had one and then it was cut off. In our culture, we cut them off. So sometimes on the ears and sometimes on the legs. Those in the local language are called Bulegyeya. That's why some people are called Bulegyeya. So Karegyeya is probably the singular term for it. Now, this is the rock. It's hanging. It has three roots. Geographers call it a hanging rock. But you heard the story from the locals. They say those roots are the ones which are holding it. So it's a house. If you look at deep, deep, deep down there, there is space. Okay? There are some parts that you can pass through and then enter there. Locals believe this was a place for Batrezi, and then these were chairs for Batrezi. These ones on the side, those ones, the big ones, those ones on the other side, the upper side, the lower side, those were their chairs. Take your trip and come to Karegyeya. This is one of the best things you can see along Ntunga Murukunjiri Road. No, they say there was a snake. My heart tells me don't go. Otherwise, I wanted to enter and show you. what's inside. Thanks for traveling with Darius. Probably I will enter next time. See you.
Weren't you once free, my Senegal? Long ago, long ago, long ago, long ago. Wow, wow.
Straight goes to Rukunjiri and Kanungu. Then you can connect from there to Ishasha, where there are tree climbing lions. And then you go down Windi National Park, where we were. If you turn right, you go to Queen Elizabeth National Park, and maybe a couple of few attractions that we shall meet along the way. We continue straight to the Renzoris.
Well.
Here we are. This is one of the things you should not miss when you pass through this route, okay? Just like the other feature we saw behind, this one has its own stories. They believe they have supernatural powers for healing diseases, cleansing diseases. So you just come and swim. This is Kitagata Hot Spring Pond in Bushenyi, former Bushenyi. I don't know if now it's called maybe Shema or things like that. I don't know the district, but if you go on the map, you'll be able to see Bushenyi. Let me take you to Kitagata Hot Spring. That's right behind me. That's Kitagata Hot Springs, as I told you. I just want to get there and, you know, ask which stories are behind the hot springs and why so many people flock this place. I'm telling you, if you see people, you can't believe it. I just thought I'm the only one, but we're a couple of them. Let me just get there and give you the story. I have to first remove my shoes so that if it means also soaking myself, I'll be able to do that. Let's go.
I have the man who is in charge of the place. I think he's going to be my guide. Welcome on the show, sir. How are you?
I'm fine, sir. How are you?
I'm good. What's your name?
Bishanga Nazario, the chairman, Kitagata Hot Springs.
Okay, great. Mr. Nazario, how are you? What happens here? I can see many people here.
So this is a healing place. It heals the people.
Okay.
In Kitagata, this is Kitagata located in Chumondo 2LC1,
okay.
Muhito Parish,
okay.
Kitagata Sub-County, Shema County,
okay.
Shema District, Western Uganda.
Oh, this is Shema.
Shema.
Former Bushenyi.
Yeah.
Okay, so what kind of diseases does this water heal?
Skin diseases, uh-huh. Fractures,
uh-huh.
Cough,
uh-huh.
Chest pain,
uh-huh.
Back pain,
oh.
Allergy,
uh-huh.
Pimples,
okay.
Lack of appetite, constipation,
hey. Oh,
wounds. It cures so many diseases.
This is endless, yeah?
Yeah.
So, do these people, how often do they come? Every day?
Every day.
Uh-huh.
So here, we have many tribes here. Yeah. Some are coming from Chiruhura,
uh-huh.
Masaka, Kabale,
okay.
Rukunjiri, Mbarara, Isinjiro, Ivanda,
wow.
Kamwenje. All tribes are here.
Uh-huh.
Some are coming even outside the country.
So
Burundi, Rwanda, Zaire.
Okay. So is there some special medicine or you just come and keep yourself? There's no other medicine?
No.
The medicine is in
You sit in the water.
Hey.
Only you know the water contains minerals,
uh-huh.
such as sulfur,
okay.
Calcium,
uh-huh.
zinc,
uh-huh.
bentonite,
okay.
manganese.
Wow.
Yeah. Ah. ETC.
So what do I do now? If I come here, now I've come, so what are we going to do?
Hey.
I'm going to change.
Hey.
Mm-hmm.
You change your clothes,
mm-hmm.
the changing place is there,
okay.
So and then you enter and you...
Let's go! I can't wait to go and heal some of the diseases. I don't know which one, because they have said everything. Let me go and draw what is not yet on me.
Wow.
So this is the changing room?
Yeah, this is the changing room.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay, great. So I remove?
Yeah, you remove good. All the clothes.
Uh-huh.
And then after, you enter the water.
I go to the water.
Yeah.
This is the water.
This is the water?
Uh-huh.
Here the people.
See, if you see all those people behind me, of course they came for healing, okay?
Yes.
I'm not here for healing, but I'm here to show you some of the things that people believe in, some of the things that are in this world that you can't believe even exist, okay? I'll go there, I try my level best to show you, all right? Very hot, huh? This is basically, it's very hot. It's very, very, very hot, I can tell you. This water, they believe it has healing powers, okay? No medicine, no nothing. Nothing we add on, okay. You don't add anything. It's very hot here, okay? I tried to step in. It looks like... Aye. Woo! It's really very hot. You can't even stay. If you're not used to the water, you can't stay even 2 minutes, okay? But they say you start with somewhere. It's a process. You have to start with somewhere, then come here, until the last process. Let me go back to the water. Eh? Okay. Here I met a gentleman who is willing to tell us his story. Okay? His story of healing, his story of, showering here, dipping yourself here, and then you get the magic. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
What's your name?
I'm called the Lay Kano de Julius Mucha.
Okay. Yeah. You're even a Kano?
Yeah, I'm a Lay Kano.
Ah, you're a Lay Kano?
Yeah.
Okay. So, in charge of Uganda?
Yes.
Okay.
Mission coordinator of Kitagata.
Oh, mission coordinator, okay.
I'm a technical teacher by profession.
Wow.
I'm an instructor.
So, yeah. Tell us.
So now, yes. The formation of this hot spring, it is as a result of volcanicity.
Okay.
Because his chemical weather is very good geography. So down there under the asphalt down there, there is what we call molten magma.
Okay.
There is the force from the other end and the force from the other end.
Okay.
So they come and they compress.
Okay.
And they compress, they squeeze that magma.
Okay.
And they are squeezing that magma, the water oozes out.
Okay.
When it's still hot. And we are hoping, or we are expecting, that any time it is, given the chassis, there will be a But our prayer is that the happens, people will not be here. That is our prayer.
To society.
To society, okay. How they are receiving it.
Yes, how do they receive it?
Now, this one they are receiving it because it's a healing place.
Okay.
The reason why they are coming here and they say it is a healing place, there are some sort of souls which are here. For example, the boiling point, you know, water boils at 100 degrees Celsius.
Yeah.
But for this one, the boiling point is 78 degrees. The reason is soluble salts lower the boiling point. The soluble salts that are in, for example, we have got sulfur, there is nitrate, there is sodium chloride, there is benzonite.
Okay.
And when we go to sulfate, that one is good at healing the wounds.
Ah, it's good at healing the
wounds. Yes, there is calcium.
Uh-huh.
You know calcium, it strengthens the bones.
Okay.
Then the benzonite is released inside in our homes.
Oh.
So as they are dancing and washing it in, they also take home water.
Okay.
So
there's even where you
they, yeah, there is, yeah.
Okay.
You see the source, they are coming like this.
Yeah.
And goes like this. Means that the hotness varies.
From here to
As it is why you see so many people there. So meaning the wetness is not as hot as,
as this side.
Yeah. So that's why they say this one is a part for men, this one is part for the women.
I'm
because they are like that. That's how they are doing. But the reason of coming here, you see when people become starting to become older, the sign of food start to grow. As they come in, the sign of start to dead. So they come and take some weeks, some months here, then at the end they go with their okay. And another thing, when you go inside here, the metabolic rate increases. And when the metabolic rate increases, means you come out when you are thirsty, you come out when you need to eat. And you know when somebody is eating, you become very healthy.
I can't imagine that. I can't really. You know, it's an amazing story.
Surely.
Thanks, Canon. I appreciate.
Yeah, okay. Welcome.
I wish you a good hearing.
I wish you the
That's
best.
That's why I'm feeling thirsty. It's because I'm from water. Food next.
But make sure even if you gather this information, you first go deep and enjoy. And let me tell you, people have devoted this one as their sauna and anything the other hot places.
The one of fire.
Because that one of fire, it eliminates in oxygen.
Okay.
You're getting there is a lot of carbon dioxide. That's why people go there and collapse.
Yes.
But when you are here,
you can't
you immerse yourself and you remain here. Yeah. So this part is getting oxygen and the other you are getting the worms.
You're hearing. I appreciate so much.
So I'm appreciating you.
Thank you so
much. Come again. Please keep on and come and get more food.
We shall be back.
Yeah, I wish you the best. Joseph, we wish you the best. Thank you for coming. God bless you so much.
We wish you God bless you too, Kalon. See you and thanks for traveling with Darius. These are the things we bring to you. Over to the next destination.
Welcome on the show and thanks for traveling with Darius. Of course, as we jumped in the hot spring, you know the excitement and everything and all people are there, the mics fell in water. And I'm so grateful to the guys behind me. They really helped me a lot to repair my microphones, Pade Electronics in Ishaka. We are so grateful. Thank you, man. Thank you so much. Welcome back on the show and thanks for traveling with Darius. After that inconvenience caused by a microphone, here we are in Ishaka town. This is like one of the busiest spots in Bushenyi, okay? You know, I just know the old towns. I don't know, these days they tell me there is Shema, there is whatever, many of them. So as you can see here, this route takes you to Kasese, this one takes you to Mbarara. And we shall be taking that route early morning to Queen Elizabeth National Park. Our road trip for today stops here and we're going to sleep at Crane Resort Hotel. It's just a few meters from Ishaka town, the busiest spot in Bushenyi. Basically, it's around 7 p.m. in Uganda. There is a saying that goes in the area that whoever digs even the hardest retires home. We are going to retire here. Oh, thanks for traveling with Darius. We are at Crane Resort Hotel in Ishaka, former Bushenyi, okay? Which district is this now?
This is Bushenyi, still Bushenyi district.
Still Bushenyi. Yeah, I thought they cut it in too many pieces and then now...
This is still
okay. Bushenyi. So, you know, I know most of you there who are watching us are salivating because of our barbecue. This is what they do here, I think, every day. Mr. Twaha is the manager and we are with Chef who?
Chef Peter!
Yes. What's your name?
Maria
is the one who delivers the meat on the table, okay? Everything on the table and then serves you very well. Good to see you, Maria. How are you? Yes, Twaha.
Yes,
good to see you.
Thanks
for traveling with Darius.
The pleasure is mine.
Tell me about Crane Resort.
Crane Resort is one of the best,
the
destinations in southwestern Uganda.
Yeah,
just a few kilometers from the best tourist destinations, Kitagata Hot Springs, Queen Elizabeth National Park, and the Karinju Conservation Area.
Who are your customers?
All types of customers. Given our location in suburban area. Uh-huh. We attract all sorts of customers, but majorly, uh-huh, we are looking at the corporate world.
Corporate world.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Party people.
Party people.
So this one here, this is where all my heart is. Yeah. This is where all my heart is.
Yeah.
You do this every day?
We do that every day.
Okay.
And for chance customers, uh-huh, and we sometimes get orders because it's really delicious.
Uh-huh.
So for you, like you who taste it, might at one point bring your family.
Yeah. Yeah.
And we do those orders.
I can't wait. I can't wait.
Yeah.
We see you at Crane Resort Hotel. Maybe some other day, so that you enjoy things like this. Thanks to Aha.
Thank you.
I'm so grateful.
We are also very grateful.
All right, thanks for traveling with Darius.
Sorry, won't let.